So today I'm going to be talking about the English. I really consider this band really a great super rock and roll band, super group, amazing rock band. Really, really good. Great band that came out of London. Really good. Which super group, the great English super group, Bad Company. So I know one of you have been requesting this for, oh geez, quite a while now. Finally getting to it. So I really, really, really hope you really enjoyed this. So I'm going to go all the way up until their 1977 album. So I don't have the Dissolution Angels, is it called? I don't have that one, but because the only song I know off that one is Rock and Roll Fantasy, which is a really, really great tune, really, really great. So that's a really, really good one, that I do know. Yeah, I know that song. I don't have that album. And then the other ones from like the 80s, not really familiar with that whatsoever. And I guess they had a different lead singer, and I really don't. I only know the era, the Paul Rodgers era of Bad Company, from from their first album all the way until probably 79, I would say. The other ones, I really don't know. Bad Company formed in Westminster, London in 1973 with singer Paul Rodgers, guitarist Mick Ralphs, and later with drummer Simon Kirk and bassist Boz Burrell. So really how this band really, came together was three bands came together. Let me say that again. Three bands came together and formed this rock band. Three bands that came, people that were in those three bands all came together to form this band. It started with, all the rock bands were like Free, which Paul Rodgers was in that band, Free, as well as Simon Kirk, the drummer. He was in Free. And when he was with Free, he must have been, I was a teenager. Man, he was, quite young, like 19, like he was almost 20. Not, I don't think quite 20, when, Paul Rodgers was probably, 19, 20, whatever. So those two were in that band. And Mick Ralphs, who was with the band Mott the Hoople from 69 until 72. He played with quite a couple albums with them. Oh, five albums I think with that band. And and then Boz Burrell, who played with King Crimson from probably, I think it was 69 or 70, played a couple, he was in that band, which, you think about King Crimson, right? They're kind of like this progressive rock, jazz rock kind of band, right? So I've done quite a few album views of all those three bands that I did talk about. If you want to check them out, I did Mott the Hoople, All the Young Dudes album review. So what I'm going to do is probably put it down below in the description, all the album views that I've done of those three bands, so you can check that out. Anyways, Bad Company's self-titled debut album is a hard rock and blues rock album, which was released on June 26th of 1974. So really, you think about, they formed in 1973, so it took them about a year, almost a year, until they had their first album out, until this band came out. But what a great band, really. What a great, great rock band. A band that, my opinion, deserved, you know, a lot of the rock albums that I did buy, so many rock bands, classic rock bands from the 70s. But this band definitely deserves to be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. But, you know, it's, I don't know, you know what I mean? Like, so many bands that did deserve, that do deserve to be in it, aren't. It's just, I don't know. Maybe one of these days, maybe one, you know, one of these days. Anyways, like I said, this is their self-titled debut album. Like I said, it's a rock and, you know, hard rock and blues rock album. So it was released on June 26th of 1974. So the songs on the album include their, which became a big hit song of theirs, Can't Get Enough. Rock Steady, that's a great song. The whole album is amazing. Then after that is, probably, you know, Mick Ralph's, I think he might have wrote it, Ready for Love, which was Mott the Hoople song, you know what I mean? It was one of their songs that was off the All the Young Dudes album, that one, which I also done an album review. And after that is a, this kind of bluesy kind of tune, Don't Let Me Down, which is pretty much played on, well, Paul Rodgers, I think, plays that on piano with guitar, you know, with Mick Ralphs and that on guitar and that. But great, great song. It's not like compared to, say, like Ready for Love, Can't Get Enough, you know. This is more kind of a mellow tone kind of song. It's more of a softer song, softer, you know what I mean? It's not as heavy, you know, as the other ones. But yeah, Don't Let Me Down, that's a great song. Then after that is Bad Company. That's a great song, Bad Company. That is The Way I Choose, which The Way I Choose, that's a great, great song. Kind of starts off a little slow, and then all of a sudden it picks up this, like, this awesome hard rocking grooving song. It's just amazing. And Moving On, which is an amazing song. That's a great song. Really great song. The whole album itself, a lot of upbeat songs that you can really dance to. It's one of those songs that, how can I put it? You know, if it's like a song that you listen to and you can't help tapping your feet or can't stop dancing, you know, it's one of those songs that are just amazing. And last is Seagull. It's pretty much played on acoustic, which is a more kind of like, another soft song, like not as heavy. It's played on acoustic, and I think it's not like Rock Steady, which is this upbeat, hard rocking tune, you know, songs like that. It's more kind of like a slower, but the whole album, 8 songs on it, the whole album itself is just unbelievable. Great, great, great album. So make sure to check out Music DVD Collection, Bad Company. So I'm going to put it down below, which I posted quite a while ago. So I'm going to put it down in the description down below, as well as free album reviews, Mott the Hoople, King Crimson, down in the description down below. But yeah, great, great, great band. What a great band. Really good. So I say, you know, the big hits that came off this album were, you know, Can't Get Enough. That I consider that song a really became quite of a very popular song even to this day. That is, and Bad Company, that one probably be still considered, that one still another big classic of theirs. But yeah, the whole album itself is. But yeah, probably not many people that, you know, listen to Bad Company didn't know that Ready for Love was a Mott the Hoople song to begin with, 2 years before this. Anyways, I go through the songs again. There's Can't Get Enough, Rock Steady, Mott the Hoople cover, Ready for Love, Don't Let Me Down, Bad Company, The Way I Choose, Moving On, and last is Seagull. So make sure to check out, like I said, music DVD collection, Bad Company, which is a pretty much like a documentary of them that I have. So check that one out. I'm going to put that in the description, as well as the other album views by those other three bands. So I'm going to start doing more of this band as well. So hit that thumbs up, and thank you for watching. I hope you really enjoyed the first album review of this. I'm going to try to do more today, see how much I can get done, and hope you really enjoyed it, and bye.